Welcome to the JFK Neuroscience Institute here at JFK University Medical Center, home to our neurology residency program in Edison, New Jersey. My name is Sean, and I'm one of the PGY4 academic chiefs. I'm going to give you part of the tour today, as well as show you how much our program has to offer. Our residency program has 27 slots, and it's categorical, so your prelim year will be here with us in internal medicine. Aside from working with all the different residents, you'll have the opportunity to work with 5 different fellowships in areas such as sleep medicine, stroke neurology, clinical neurophysiology, neurocritical care, and endovascular surgical neuroradiology. We'll start our tour here in the neuroscience conference area. We spend a lot of time here as we have morning report and new conference every day. Here, we have resident, fellow, and attending run lectures, and with the interactive whiteboard, we're able to open up patient charts, review imaging, and draw out neural pathways. When you're on call, one of the most common areas you'll be is in the ER code stroke retrieval area. This is where EMS drops off pre-hospital code strokes to be seen by the ER attending and the responding code stroke team immediately upon arrival. Here, we get a brief history, a quick physical exam, and rush them to the ER CAT scan. Here in the ER CAT scan area, it's residents who get to decide what CT studies to order, whether that's non-contrast CT, CT angiogram, or more cutting-edge CT perfusion studies. Since we have a nursing team respond to each code stroke with us, we're able to give blood pressure medications, stabilize the patients, and even prepare TPA to give to patients while they're still on the CAT scan table. For patients presenting with large vessel occlusion within window, residents can call a code neuro intervention. Then they're rushed here to our neuro intervention suite, where we have 2 neuroangiography suites with physiologic monitoring. We also have 2 neuroimaging stations to review neuroimaging. Everyone graduating from our program has confidence in reviewing all types of neuroimaging, including non-contrast CT, CT angiograms, CT perfusions, digital subtraction angiography, and MRI. For anyone being admitted for a TIA or stroke workup, they come here to 3 North, our stroke unit. Here, we have specialized nurses who take care of each of our stroke patients. These nurses also come to any in-hospital code stroke with us to help stabilize the patient, get imaging, and even give TPA. For our sickest patients, they come here to our neurocritical care unit. During the day, we have neurocritical care fellows and residents working here, and at night, there's an on-call neuro resident senior who's watching after the neuro ICU. At any time in the neuro ICU, we have neurosurgery patients, neurointervention patients, and patients being treated for hemorrhagic or large ischemic strokes, status epilepticus, Guillain-Barré syndrome, and myasthenic crisis. Some of the cool things we have in the neurocritical care unit is our portable CT scan and the portable hyperfine MRI. Behind these doors is our epilepsy monitoring unit. Each week, the pediatric and adult epileptologists have elective admissions where their patients are connected to long-term video EEG. Here, we adjust their anti-epileptic medication regimen, and we can see real-time how their EEG is affected. We also have 24-hour EEG capabilities for anyone presenting with status epilepticus.
Hi, I'm Denisette Torres, Administrative Chief Resident, and I'm here to show you around our outpatient clinic area. Here, residents have their weekly continuity clinic, and attendings also see their subspecialty patients, which gives us as residents the unique opportunity to work with them with this patient population. Here, we also work with a sleep neurologist and help read sleep studies. We also, as residents, manage our own weekly lumbar puncture clinic. Here we have our neuro-ophthalmology suite, where we do our visual field testing and have our fundoscopy machine. And for patients experiencing dizziness, our neuro-otologists have a camera which captures nystagmus on film. Here in the neurophysiology room, the neurophysiologists guide us through conducting EMGs and nerve conduction studies. By the end of our training, we're able to conduct these independently. Here in the EEG room, we read and discuss EEGs with the attendings who then oversee us. By the end of the residency, we read these independently. During this rotation, we also work very closely with the neurophysiology fellow. Here's our last stop, our resident lounge. When we're not seeing patients or attending lecture, this is where you'll find most of us. Here, we take advantage of the computer workstations where we have access to various research databases. We also partake in impromptu group study sessions here. Our residency program has a strong focus on research. Since we have many subspecialists, we're able to take advantage and collaborate with the neurophysiologists, neurointensivists, neurocritical care physicians, sleep physicians, and a lot of other various subspecialties to work on research together. Residents submit abstracts for publication and are actually able to present their own work at national conferences, like the American Academy of Neurology and the International Stroke Conference.
Now we've reached the end of our tour. Thank you for taking the time to visit with us.
We're proud of our program's history and the constant changes we are making to make it even better. We hope you'll consider our program as part of your professional journey.